Interacting with your customers on social sites like YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter is a big deal. It encourages brand recognition, helps you reach customers on a personal level, adds rank juice to the SERP, so on and so on. You know this. Everyone knows this. What you may not know is the important details behind your social pages, where they're ranked on Google, and what keywords they're ranking on. Here at SpyFu, we've worked really hard on integrating social metrics for websites and their pages, both for your site and your competitors, to give you the full scope how everything is performing. Now you might be thinking, Patrick, your striking features and melodic voice make me want to continue watching this video. But I already have tools that help me track metrics on my social sites. Oh, you mean like Facebook Insights for your likes and shares? YouTube Analytics for your comments and watch duration? Maybe you mean Twitter Analytics for your retweets and responses? Or Google Analytics for your ranks and clicks? Could you possibly mean a plugin like Jetpack for WordPress? Do you see where I'm going with this? That's a huge surplus of tools. How do you even carry all that? Plus, it's only information for your social networks. You have no idea how your competition is doing on the social front. And thirdly, it usually only shows you internal data, how your Facebook page is performing on Facebook, not the wider web. Managing all of these systems can be a burden to the point where you spend too much time overanalyzing it, or you outsource it, or you just ignore it. We don't want you to just ignore it. We want you to be awesome on all of your online fronts. So we're going to show you how your social pages, as well as your competitors, are performing on Google, so you can finally give them the love and attention as you do your own domain, the love and attention they deserve. SpyFu tracks online data for millions of websites around the web. This includes Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, LinkedIn, and blogs from different domains. Are you hoping your new Pinterest album gains some traction in SEO? That's exactly what the Desi Group did when they wanted to rank on pink bridesmaids dresses. They created an entire Pinterest board based solely on pink bridesmaids dresses to maximize their presence on that keyword and its relating keywords, with the hope that they could snag multiple ranks on Google. And it worked. They are currently ranking both second and third on Google for that keyword, one for their domain, the other for that specific Pinterest board. If you enter this board's URL into SpyFu, we'll tell you what other keywords it's ranking on and where they're showing up in the SERP, not to mention how much those ranks and clicks would be worth if you bought them in AdWords. And as a special treat, SpyFu also tracks things like likes, shares, tweets, and pins, so you can see how your content is performing not only on Google, but on social sites as well. Let me give you another example. I'm going to type the word tabletop into Google. Now you may think this thrilling search is going to lead us to, well, tops of tables, but you would be wrong. The top hit is actually for the site tabletop.geekandsundry.com, followed by a YouTube playlist. That's because Tabletop is a popular YouTube series put on by Geek and Sundry and hosted by Wil Wheaton. Obviously in SpyFu, you can see how that tabletop.geekandsundry link is doing, but what about that playlist? It's kind of a long, weird URL. Well, let's paste it into SpyFu and see what happens. Is your mind blown? My mind was blown when I saw this. This is how this individual YouTube playlist is performing on Google. The keywords it's ranking on, the estimated traffic and SEO value of those keywords, and how much social love this playlist is getting. Let's compare that with an individual video from Tabletop. Holy crap, right? I mean, seriously. Here's one single piece of content hosted on YouTube and how it's performing on Google. You may or may not know this, but I do some work on YouTube, so I geek out hard about this stuff. Getting this information from anywhere else is like pulling teeth. It's impossible. But on SpyFu, it's just a copy and paste. This is how you begin to own the space. This is how you take over a Google SERP page. We've been told that adding tags, proper titles, and descriptions are important to get content noticed. But this is the first time that you can really see it in action. If you leverage a set of keywords across all of your social sites, then you have an opportunity not only to come in at the top rank, but the second, third, fourth and fifth all simultaneously. If nothing else, this means that your competitors are going to have a much harder time to rank on your brand name. And that's a big deal, right? It's a big deal to us. This is the big picture. A domain's success is no longer just the performance of its pages, but all the external social sites and how potential customers interact with them. Google recognizes this as well, and ranks content from social sites just as much as from a domain, sometimes more so. It's no longer entirely about owning the top rank for a certain keyword, but dominating the first page of Google for it. Understanding this big picture is important to understand what social networks you're most successful on. Desi Group's target audience may not be scouring the bowels of Twitter, but believe me, they're on Pinterest, like, all day, while watching Say Yes to the Dress. What social networks or blogs or individual pieces of content are you ranking highest on? What unique keywords are coming from these social sites? Adding to that strategy, where should certain pieces of content be promoted? When you gain a little momentum, this is also a great way to show a client. This is how your brand is performing on the web as a whole. You may not always get exact conversion numbers from social sites, but increased awareness of your brand almost always leads to more money in your pocket. Again, if we go back to the Desi Group example, not only are they gaining social presence and a rank on Google, many of the pins on their Pink Bridesmaids Dresses board funnels the browser to a specific purchasable product on their website. Now, with all of that said, our software isn't perfect. For example, I wonder how Geek & Sundry's Facebook is doing. A ton of social love, but not a lot in terms of SEO keywords. Sundry and write fan fiction. Something about this cues a red flag in my brain, because I feel like their Facebook should rank on their brand name, right? Hey look, it does. This is an important side note about SpyFu. Even though we track millions upon millions of keywords, both common and obscure, it's tough to catch them all, much like Pokemon. This is especially true when it comes to brand names. SpyFu hasn't been tracking the keyword geek and sundry, so I'm going to add it in. I'm going to go to my account and click on Request Keywords and add in Geek and Sundry. SpyFu will start tracking this keyword once we update our data, which is once a month. But don't get me wrong, we do have Facebook data, and Twitter data, Google Plus data. You can even dig into your personal or your company's LinkedIn data to see what keywords your business profile is ranking on. All of this can lead to great opportunities with this, and I lost my train of thought. I just really want a chicken chalupa supreme right now.
Competitive intelligence, that's it.
Were you ever like, damn that Taco Bell, how are they ranking on Dorito tacos and I'm not? What are they doing to lead so many people to their Facebook page? Then you realize that Facebook post was a taco giveaway announcement that got 67,000 likes, 3,700 comments, and 13,000 shares. So maybe you can't do a taco giveaway. Someone selling wedding supplies can be inspired by the Desi Group's Pinterest boards. Or for someone like me, who's like, damn that Wil Wheaton! What is he doing to get his playlist and so many individual videos ranked on organically? How does one achieve so much traffic to one's videos? To realize he's adding huge descriptions to his videos, including links to individual Twitter handles, to a specific product, and a full transcript of every video, which probably contributes to the strength of the playlist we saw ranking so highly on the keyword tabletop. From this point, I'll use my own discretion regarding my content. I don't like super long descriptions. I think it dilutes the keyword cocktail. But adding in social profiles and a full transcript could really help the ranking of this video, as well as overall social link juice. Using SpyFu as a hub for your pieces of content, whether they be on your site or on a social network, is the fastest way to get important information about you and your competition's content universe. Use it to gain inspiration and insight about your blogs and social updates, and own the space on Google. Thank you for watching.